Hello students, I hope you all are doing good. So today we are going to start with our first topic in our English lesson. So what is the first topic? The town mouse and the country mouse. Yes, so here we are going to know the comparison, know the differences of their lifestyles in this topic. How a country mouse will live and how a town mouse will live. Okay, so here town means city and country means village. Town mouse means the mouse which lives in city. Country mouse means the mouse that lives in village. So this is our topic. So if you come to page number 1, here there are pictures given, two pictures given to you, which tells you the difference between a town and village. How the entire environment looks like. I hope you all are looking into your textbook. So here we have the actual A reading from page number 2. In this page number 2, before starting with this topic, I want you all to hold a pencil in your hand and start underlining the words for which you don't understand meaning. The town mouse and the country mouse. The town mouse and the country mouse were cousins. They often wrote to each other. One day, the country mouse got this letter from his cousin. So, who wrote a letter? This town mouse wrote a letter to country mouse. What is the letter? We will see here. Dear cousin, I have been ill with cough and my doctor feels I need a holiday. He has advised me to spend a week in the countryside. May I stay with you? Please give me an early reply. See, the town mouse wants to live along with country mouse. Town mouse wants to stay in countryside for a week because this is not in good condition, good health condition. So the doctor advised town mouse to take rest in countryside. So town mouse wrote a letter to country mouse that, can I visit your place? Do we say yes or no if someone wants to come to our place? We obviously say yes, you're always welcome. The same way country mouse welcomed town mouse. Receiving the invitation from the country mouse, the town mouse packed his bags and caught the next train to the countryside. The day was bright and sunny and soon the town mouse began to feel hot in the train. So as soon as this town mouse received a letter from his cousin, very immediately it packed its baggage, everything for a week and moved to railway station and immediately caught the very next train. So how is the train? It is an ordinary train, a very normal train where there is no AC. So this town mouse is expecting AC in train and it's also feeling that it is a terrific journey, it is a terrible journey. It is very hot, the day is so bright and sunny and it started feeling hot in the train. I wish there was an air conditioned coach, he said to himself. I feel very uncomfortable here. Who is feeling uncomfortable here? Town mouse is feeling uncomfortable in this train. However, there was nothing he could do about it. Can we do anything once we get into the compartment? No, we can do nothing. So he grumbled to himself while the train chugged slowly into the country. Slowly the train is moving and moving, and when this train moved into the countryside, he was grumbling himself, such a horrible train, such a terrific train journey. I cannot make it at all. I can't even imagine this kind of journey in my life. All these things he was grumbling to himself. Okay, so as soon as he saw his cousin, he said, "Oh cousin," the town mouse said as soon as he got off the train. "The train was dreadful and I feel terribly hot and thirsty. If we go on a long journey, we feel thirsty, we feel tired, yes. And first of all, the day was very hot and he was thirsty. I hope you have something ice cold for me to drink at home. So what is he expecting? He is expecting a cold or chilled water. And he asked, I think you must have arranged ice cold water at home. Then what is the answer of this country mouse? Well, I have some water, said the country mouse. I have water, but not ice cold water. But I can look around for some coconut water if you like. What he said, I have normal water, not chilled water, but I can arrange coconut water if you really want. Then the expression of town mouse is, coconut water, asked the town mouse in horror. Don't you have any orange juice or lemonade? Don't you have orange juice or at least lemon juice, we call it lemonade. So don't you have that at home? I'm afraid not, replied his cousin. So the country mouse said, I don't have all those things, but I found a very nice piece of root today and a tender bit of sugar cane. I'm sure you will enjoy that. What he said, I don't have lemonade, I don't have orange juice, I have normal water. If you want, I can arrange coconut water. But I have arranged something which is very tasty, a tender bit of sugar cane and a fresh root for us to enjoy. Root? Sugar cane? The town mouse exclaimed. But I don't eat raw food like that, said the town mouse. I don't eat raw food. I want cooked food or baked food. That is the intention of town mouse. The country mouse said, this is what we eat in the country. So I'm afraid you too have to eat this. Try it, it's not bad. So the country mouse is trying to convince a town mouse to taste whatever is available with him then. He's telling that it is not so bad, it tastes good, why don't you try? The country mouse said, this is what we get in the countryside. The town mouse did not enjoy the dinner at all. He nibbled at the root and the sugar cane and then said he wanted to sleep. He just bit a little and he said, I want to sleep. He really didn't enjoy the food at all. The country mouse showed a corner in the mouse hole and said, there you are, you can sleep there. In one corner of that mouse hole, he said, you have to sleep there. There is no bed, there is no bed sheet, there is no pillow. Just on the cold, hard ground, he is supposed to sleep. Look at his expressions now. On the ground, asked the town mouse, do I have to sleep on the ground? Yes, this is how we sleep in the country, his cousin answered. That is how they sleep in the villages. As the town mouse lay down on the hard, cold ground, he suddenly thought of something. Cousin, he called out. He called out very loudly. Who? Town mouse called out very loudly. Cousin. So, yes, what is it? The country mouse asked. Why is it so quiet here? Where are all the cars and lorries? Where are the radios and televisions? Where are all the lights? See, in cities we have sounds of cars, autos, lorries, buses. There will be a noise from neighborhood, from TVs or radios, and lights will be turned on even in the midnight. So that is what this town mouse is expecting even at country. But do we get that? Do we have the same situation there? No. So that is what is worrying. So the country mouse replies this way. This is how it is in the country, his cousin replied. It's always quiet in the country. Sometimes it is quieter than today. My grandfather says that our village is the quietest among all the villages in our district. So here we have quiet and quieter. Quiet, quieter, quietest. So here we have positive, comparative and superlative. Degrees of comparison. Recap, degrees of comparison. Quiet, quieter, quietest. Tall, taller, tallest. Yes, positive, comparative and superlative degree. Oh, is it? The country is a strange place, said the town mouse. But he said to himself, I don't think I like this place. Why doesn't this town mouse like this place? It is very hot, he had to sleep on the ground. It is very cold, it is very hard. And there is no lemonade, there is no juice, there is no chilled water. Yes, there is no air condition there. And food is also not good there. He is eating only sugar cane or a root which is not cooked. It's not even baked. Yes, so he said to himself that I did not like this place at all. Next morning, the town mouse found that there was no breakfast ready. Breakfast is not ready. Then what we have to do? We have to go in search of breakfast. That is what the country mouse tells. Cousin, let's go. Let's find breakfast. We will have fresh root and fresh sugar cane, tender bit of sugar cane. We are sure to find something there, he said. A nice piece of root or a tender bit of sugar cane. But the town mouse had enough. Enough is enough. I can't bear this anymore. Okay, so the town mouse got an idea and he said, thank you, cousin. But I think I'll catch the next train home. I have suddenly remembered that I have forgotten something at home. So he is making all reasons to make home. Actually, I'm very happy for the hospitality, but I forgot something at home. I have to do that immediately. So I have to immediately catch the next train. Okay, so it finally made it and the town mouse went back to its hometown. So happily he will eat whatever he wants, he will drink whatever he wants and he'll have a comfortable life there. A few days later, the country mouse wrote a letter to town mouse. And here is the letter. My dear cousin, I hope you are well. I am worried about you. I would like to visit you and make sure you are all right. Your cousin, country mouse. So now it's time for country mouse to visit town mouse. So I just want you all to imagine what all things will trouble country mouse. So far we discussed what all this town mouse had faced. Yes, so now it is turn of country mouse because country mouse is visiting town now. So what all will disturb the peace of country mouse? Just imagine, keep your thoughts ready. I'll catch you all again in the next video. With beautiful conclusion of this topic. Catch you all tomorrow. Thank you, children.